What is a program or pricing template? Click on your profile and you'll see a section down here called Manage Programs. Click on that and you may see some information here about programs that you currently have installed in the system here. Now, first of all, let me explain what a program is. A program combines several different elements. Let's click on the details of this Interchange Plus program here. The first thing you're going to notice about a program is that it has the volume qualifications. And so this particular program is going to show up for any merchant no matter what their processing volume might be. But let me show you how we might edit that. What if down here we decided that we did not want this program to show up for merchants that did less than $3,000 in volume? We also didn't want it to show up for merchants doing more than $30,000 in volume. We click Save. Now you'll see that this program is only going to be available for merchants that process more than $3,000, or from $3,000, I'm sorry, up to $30,000. So if somebody processes $2,900, this program is not available to them. If somebody processes $31,000, this program is not available to them. So the first part of a program is the volume requirements for it. The second part of a program is the residual split. So if you enter your costs for all of the different fees, these costs come from your Schedule A, you can also enter your percentage split, and this will enable you to see what your residual or margins would be on an account so that you can make a more educated decision about where to place this merchant, with which processor, which program you want to use, as well as making sure the pricing is advantageous to create some profit for you when you're out in the field making a sale. So we have the residual. The third component of a program is the pricing template. And so the pricing template includes a default price. So you can see this one has 25 basis points of markup, a cost. This is the Schedule A cost from the ISO or the processor, and then a minimum. So this is as low as you can go. Sometimes you go down to cost. Sometimes you're not allowed to go all the way down to cost. So you have your default, your cost, and your minimum. The next thing that you need to understand about programs is that not every user has the ability to edit programs. If you have the ability to edit a particular program, then you can click on Edit, or you can click on the details of any of these fees and click on Edit up here at the top. So let's say we wanted to change this to be 40 basis points of markup, and maybe our Schedule A cost was 4 basis points, and we said we don't want to go any lower than 15 basis points, we could make that change. If you are not able to change a program, but you have a question about it, you need to reach out to your ISO administrator who's administrating the account and created the program, and they can make those adjustments for you. Lastly, and before we dive into much more detail of programs in the next video, please understand that if you get confused about the programs at all, understand that the programs are by far the most confusing part and the most complicated part of using this software. And it is not designed for the new green agent who's just getting started in the field. Please make sure you reach out to support, talk to your ISO administrator or to our support team, and reach out to us, and we will help you build whatever programs you need and make sure that everything gets set up correctly. Because once your programs are created correctly and are set in place, everything else about the software is extremely user-friendly and easy for you to get started right away.